Live now, die later. I'm joined by the phenomenal Hugh Hefner. Thank you for talking to us.
My pleasure.
How often has sex changed before you started Playboy?
Sex in America has changed, and behavior has changed dramatically. When I first published Playboy magazine, and certainly when I grew up and when I was in college, having a baby out of wedlock was a scandal. A scandal that drove some people to suicide. Abortion was illegal. Oral sex was a major felony. Even oral sex inside of marriage was illegal. And very few people know that. Playboy played a major part in changing all those laws.
So has the Playboy lifestyle changed due to the recession?
I see no evidence that Playboy's lifestyle has changed has fallen out of favor. People may not be spending as much money, but I don't think that spending money has much to do with Playboy lifestyle. I think a Playboy lifestyle really has to do with an attitude towards life. I was raised in a very Puritan home, a prohibitionist home, a very repressive home, a home in which there was not a lot of hugging and kissing. The Playboy philosophy makes a case for life as a celebration, with a suggestion that there is more to life than simply a veil of tears, that life should be lived with a little style. And you can do that if you are wealthy or if you are working on relatively lesser means. I think it has to do with attitude on life.
Your possession deals in pornographic imagery, and it's evil on women. How do you take that?
I think we have to start with the notion of by industry. If you're talking about the magazine never, ever has been anything even remotely related to pornography. If you think that, and if you label pinup pictures, pictures of nude ladies or semi-nude as pornography, then there is nothing that is erotic. And that is just a matter of labeling.
So, Hugh, are you an active feminist?
I'm not an active feminist, I'm an activist humanist. I separated ways from the American feminist movement when they became anti-sexual. I believe that embracing sexuality is a part of what it means to be free. Women have been historically the ones who have paid the greatest price for our very irrational attitudes historically related to sex. It's women who have been held in a place of bondage as second-class citizens, and all that is changing, and I'm very much in favor of that.
How can you conspire the detrimental of women from using them as sex models and being a priority and producer of them into pornotic magazines?
I don't even know what it means, because that's a question that is so loaded with the language that you have to separate it into its real meaning. What is wrong with celebrating women as sex objects? Isn't that a part of what we're doing? Isn't that a part of what life is all about? If women were not sex objects, there wouldn't be another second generation. Women are sex objects. That doesn't mean they're not human beings. To be a sex object and to be desired gives a woman a tremendous amount of power. It makes the world go round. Sex and the attraction between the sexes does make the world go round.
So, Mr. Hefner, you're basically turning around and saying that women are sex objects. Would you like it if a male was portraying as a sex object? You don't really see this magazine that you're putting out with men in it. It's all women. You take people into your bedrooms. You make them have sex with you to become a Playboy bunny. Don't you see yourself as a dirty old man?
Not for a moment. I'm on the side of the angels and always have been. I consider myself, on a serious note, a very moral man and always have. And morality has always been very, very important to me.
So how many times do you have sex these days?
Well, more often than than in the recent past because I have a bunch of new girlfriends. I would say on average 3 or 4 times a week. The busiest time is the weekend. Everybody's here.
Is sex still as good when you get older?
I wish I remembered more clearly. I would say that sex is better now. But of course I know a few more tricks than I knew back then. And everybody is a good deal more liberated today than they were back then. So it's a different kind of sex. And, you know, it's no secret that I have more than one girlfriend, and that makes things a lot more interesting.
Do you ever get sick of the Playboy lifestyle, and why don't you just really want to get rid of it, get away from it, and settle down?
I've tried it both ways. I've been married twice, and the only time I wasn't having a lot of sex was while I was married. And I have also expressed on more than one occasion that it is easier to deal with several girlfriends than one wife. I think there is no single answer to happiness. And I think that the expression different strokes for different folks is really true. You know, this is right now as happy a time as I've ever enjoyed. But if I look back over the years, the happiest times for me were the times in the early stages of romantic love. It keeps you young. Young love, new love, it keeps you young.
Okay, we'll have a song now.
Nothing, and you're bound to tell yourself, man.
What's up, no deal with me, Jim and Dawn? I enjoy better fun than all you, Hefner. Why not retire? Why not let go?
Because I think that retirement is the first step towards the grave.
Okay, you're planning to buy back all the shares that are owned by the public of that own Playboy. You, of course, you own Playboy as well. Why do you want to buy back the public shares?
The company in this particular economic climate is not being properly dealt with. I mean, it's worth a good deal more than what it's being traded for.
Okay, what's the greatest success about doing Playboy other than making porn and sex type stuff?
The greatest success of the company and the magazine was in the 1950s and 60s when we were private. And maybe it's recapturing my youth. The future of the brand, the future of the magazine, and staying the course and making certain that it's going in the right direction and will be there long after I'm gone. That rabbit, that trademark, is famous everywhere.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Hefner. We're going to have another track, and it's time for us to go as well. Thank you for talking to us, and stay safe. Mustang Sally. Guess you better slow than Mustang.